will raise their points if they find something wrong in the speaker delegate speech. The speaker delegate may justify, accept his or her mistake. After this, voting for simple majority will be carried out in informal way for the agenda. Now, let's begin with the roll call. Delegate of UK. Delegate of Israel. Delegate of Pakistan. Delegate of India. Delegate of China. Delegate of Afghanistan. Delegate of France. Delegate of Germany. Delegate of Kazakhstan. Delegate of Russia. Delegate of USA. Is there any motion on the floor? WP's wanted country as well as France. The France government had critically condemned this movement of Taliban and showed his disappointment against the self-made government by Taliban in Afghanistan. On 30 October, Taliban made a press release that if world do not recognize them as their government, then the problem of the region would turn into the problem of the world. This press release of Taliban created panic as well as anger in the minds of all the country as well as France. Being a very peaceful and virgin country, France was strongly condemning this movement of Taliban. Because my government thinks if Taliban expands its territory beyond Afghanistan, then France will be the prime target of Taliban so that they have their line clear for world capture. This is also a serious concern to the peace of the whole world because it creates a rat race among the powerful countries to expand their territories over the poor countries forcefully. So France government criticized this in its initial stage. According to France ideology, the terrorist group should be rejected in its early stage as, like in Afghanistan, due to newly formed government, the poverty rate climbs, hunger soars, and the economy tanks. Hundreds and thousands of people leave their homes, joining the millions of Afghans who are already displaced. This same condition can also happen in France as well as other countries if this will not be stopped in very as well as initial stage. France government also took thousands of Afghan refugees through airlift and helped them start a new phase of life. In France, President Emmanuel Macron said, "We must anticipate and protect ourselves against major irregular migratory flows that could endanger those who use them and feed trafficking of all kinds." This will strongly help in restricting Taliban from expanding their territory. Also, in August 2021, France closed its embassy in Kabul due to the return of the Taliban in the power. France has also expressed disappointment, saying the group so far has failed to live up to its promises of opening more moderate and inclusive style of leadership. Also, France refuses to recognize or have any type of relationship with this government, as it is all up to the Taliban if they want the other countries to have international relations with them. At the last, France believes their success in everybody's peace. With this, I rest my case. Thank you.
My question.
Hello. My question for America is, you did talk about the people that are facing threat in Afghanistan. What about the people that are in Syria and Iran that are in F by you and are born every day by you?
You did talk about the people that are facing threat in Afghanistan. What about the people of Iran and Syria which are left by you and are facing US bombings every day?
Can you repeat it?
It's about peace. You started with peace and not with war. And bombings not peace still.
Delegate of Pakistan, your spoon falsehoods on national stage, and that is not so this stage at all.
Kunalika is the one that led to the movement of Afghanistan. Kunalika is the one that led to the movement of Taliban in Afghanistan.
Do you have any moral pride thing that my home land can afford to lose more of men than sons in the Afghan civil war, which is not even a responsibility of fight in the first place? We have lost 2,300 soldiers, by the way. I would like to say that two strategic commanders, China and Russia, would love nothing more than the U.S. to continue to funnel billions of American dollars and have our sons and daughters be killed. American troops should not and will not fight in a war and die in a war. That's not that the Afghani people are not willing to fight for themselves.
You were not able to use your cost policy. You gave your useful assets to Afghanistan that are in Afghanistan right now, and I used my Taliban.
We gave Afghanistan infrastructure to America. We didn't give them that for the Taliban.
That is used for Taliban, no. Every country uses a cost policy. That should be used, and no, that assets are used by Taliban and are a threat to world peace.
I don't understand you.
There is a cost earth policy that destroys all the assets that are made by the country for no purpose uses of any
We spent over 20 years giving Afghanistan the proper infrastructure to help them
fight. When you were leaving the country, why did you destroy that assets? Because these are going to be used by Taliban now.
We didn't think about that.
My question to America is that being a superpower, you must have Afghanistan from the Taliban. That being the superpower of the world, you must have helped Afghanistan from the Taliban.
What was the question again?
Question was that being a world power, you must have helped Afghanistan from the Taliban.
We helped Afghanistan for over 20 years. We provided them with the proper infrastructure, we provided them with the right equipment.
I'm not talking about infrastructure.
Yeah.
It was a situation that you must have helped Afghanistan.
We did help Afghanistan to fight the civil war, which was not after fighting the first place.
But you left your troops from there.
Well, how do you think we should afford to lose way? How do you think that my homeland can afford to lose so many more sons of American religion? How do you think that?
I'm saying that you are rich, you are the world power,
yes.
You are rich in nuclear weapons also, so you must help us.
We've fought it for 20 years, I think that's enough.
Moreover, I want to ask a more question, that is, when you left Afghanistan, you left your weapons over there. Have you done it purposefully?
No, we did not do that purposefully.
It was a mistake.
It was a mistake. And we regret it. Thank you.
Do you have any questions?
Yes.
Taliban was funded by America in 1989. After 9/11, you declared them terrorists. What was you doing in the past?
We went there to find revenge. We went there to find the people.
You were fighting USSR, not America there. The Cold War was on the peak and you started fighting with Mujahideen for funding them to destroy the USSR.
We went there for 2 weeks to find those who attacked on 9/11.
That was later. But in 1989, you funded Taliban. You funded Taliban?
So Taliban was not a product of the USA, that's what you're suggesting. It was a product of Russia. The Soviet Union had a major problem.
The Cold War was the major part of that, and the major participants were USSR and USSR.
I
don't
understand. How about
you
answer your question?
The participants, the major participants of Cold War was USSR and USA. US Afghanistan was a communist country.
Soviet Union made Afghanistan a communist country, don't you know that?
Noor Mohammed, the Iraqi was the president.
Yes. And England made him with another?
England was, India next
Afghanistan in 1918. The last one was found in 1918.
Yes, sir.
And you did funded Mujahideen to find Yusuf. And after that, the groups divided and formed Taliban. And that after that, I was Muslim. And you declared terrorism after that.
All I have to say is that Taliban is the product of the Soviet Union.
It is the
project.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
I asked the delegate of France, what have you done to help Afghan people to come out from Afghanistan?
Both sides have to take up.
Yeah. You can't bomb that much, son. 66 generals.
You have to. It's from their side also.
To like cost 66 generals a life.
In war, we have to do so. And this is a personal situation. It's not related to Taliban at all.
It's related to the peace, man. Related to the bullet.
But agenda is Taliban. That is a personal situation.
How can you talk about that? Yeah, Michael.
Moreover, Israel always support peace. That's why the president also got the Nobel Peace Prize. When there was war between Egypt and Israel.
And you have not the policing, that's a peace step?
No, I'm saying the we support Palestinians and Palestinians do support us. But we don't support we don't support the ideology of the people who are living in Gaza Strip.
Leader of Shromi Akali Dal, Mr. Bajaj. passed a law that they would financially support the farmers as by providing some machines and some biochemical fertilizers to the farmers.
Do you think that you have provided enough infrastructure to the farmers?
Not yet, but we will in the future.
Then the farmers are on the road for the last 1 year. Then when will you provide them? They are just committing suicides from many years. When will the infrastructure be provided?
Many machines have been provided to the big farmers, but it is not possible to provide so much machines to all the farmers present in the country.
Big farmers can afford themselves. There is a need to provide infrastructure to the small farmers and the marginal farmers.
Yes, but the poor farmers, the big farmers can afford the machines, but it is still not possible for all the poor farmers to get them.
Yes, then it is your duty to provide them at the subsidized rate.
Does you think by providing the machines, this trouble can be controlled?
It cannot be controlled totally, but it can be reduced. If we provide many machines, then some of the farmers might stop burning the trouble.
But this thing is not done. Yes. Yes.
Any other point of information? Now the next MLA, please.
The lack of cooperation of the central government with our state government. Starting with the quote, farmer is the only man in the economy who buys everything at retail, sells everything at wholesale, and pays the freight both ways. Being an agrarian economy, Punjab is often targeted, may it be in positive way or it may be in the negative. Often, allegations are imposed on the farmers for burning the useless material after harvesting paddy. But why nobody thinks that if parali burning is injurious to health, then farmers are the first to face the danger. But they are forced to do the same. They cannot afford to buy super seeders as they are much expensive. Machines are not easily available. Also, farmers defy it as there is a short window between the harvesting of paddy and sowing of wheat. Paddy residue also cannot be used for animal fodder as it is harder to chew, has low calorific value and high silica content. Pandemic also increased some sort of burning as there is shortage of labor. Speaking with the farmers, they explain that some of the super seeders which have been provided by the government have such a low quality that they have seen deterioration in the crop soil. Our government is providing 50-80% subsidy to the farmers and cooperative societies to buy modern farm equipment for installing paddy, straw-based farm plants, and running a massive awareness campaign against burning. Sufficient funds are not being provided by the central government. They are busy in making the statues going to the forest tools. No attention is being given to the farmers who are on the road for the last 1 year. My dears, no Ambani, no Adani can survive without the farmers. So stop filling the pockets of these private cooperatives and imposing allegations on these innocent people. Try to cooperate with us so that the backbone of the nation have enough infrastructure, and please provide proper funds so that we can stop this burning along with bringing smiles on our farmers' faces. Thank you.
Any questions?
in your speech you thought that the central government is not providing the funds, but then the last year 2021-22 there are 491 CR provided by the central government.
The number of farmers are so much large that the machinery provided by the central government is not sufficient for the farmers.
But at the last 4 years, not 2021-22, there are 151.48 CR provided by the central government. This is not sufficient.
Okay, let's take an example of a village named Rogla. There are around 1200 farmers there, and the machines provided by the government are 5. Do you think that these machines are sufficient for them?
No. Yes, you are right. But they can only
do the harvesting of paddy and the sowing of wheat. And how can they use them? 1200 farmers, 5 machines.
But you can also provide them.
State government does not get sufficient funds from the central government. We are already providing 50-80% funds from our own treasury.
But we provided this instruction. You get instruction. I told this 491 CR last year.
Then I am also saying that the number of farmers are very large in Punjab. The most of the wheat and rice are grown in Punjab.
Present here today, I, MP6 of Trinamool Congress, want to raise reform laws. Our party was founded in January 1998 by Mamata Banerjee. Our party, All India Trinamool Congress, is popularly called as Trinamool Congress. We have passed TMC's poll to be 5 lakh jobs per year. We have also implemented the scheme of free door-to-door free delivery ration. We have increased the farmers' income. Our motive is to raise the standard of living of farmers. Under BJP's rule, farmers have many drawbacks. The rate of farmer suicide has increased. The BJP appeared the minimum support percentage, 50% of their produce. If someone do not fulfill their demand, then the party wouldn't acquire their land. Then BJP has won the last elections by saying the development of the country, but I can't see any development. Even the country is just going down day by day. Due to these farm laws, we can see that states will not be able to get revenue. They won't be able to collect money if the middleman has been removed. The entire trade moves out from the mandis to the commission agents and they will be left free. The mishandling of the Kashmir is also a big mistake of BJP. The party is nothing but evil to poor and God to rich. As we all can see that India is a democratic country and the rights of farmers are violated. They have raised their voice but there is no action. Does BJP forget that this is a democratic country? Government has to work according to people, not people have to work according to government. So they should